The town of Harrow's End was no stranger to strange occurrences, but nothing had ever been as unsettling as the arrival of the Silent Ones. It began with whispers. Rumors passed from one neighbor to the next about the eerie figures who had been seen at night standing at the edge of the woods. They never moved, never spoke. They just watched. People claimed that they saw them standing in their yards or on the outskirts of town, always just far enough away to be barely noticeable. But what was most disturbing was the complete and utter silence that followed them. Birds would stop chirping, the wind would cease, and even the sounds of your own breath seemed to disappear when the Silent Ones were near. At first, they appeared only sporadically, and only a few people claimed to have seen them. But as the nights grew longer, more and more of the townspeople began to notice the strange, pale figures lingering at the edge of the shadows, watching and waiting. Tom was one of the first to confront the Silent Ones. A local farmer, he had heard the stories but dismissed them as nonsense. One night, while walking back from the barn, he noticed a figure standing in his field. Tall, thin, and barely visible in the dim light of the moon, the figure was completely still, facing his house. Annoyed, Tom marched towards it, calling out for the trespasser to leave his property. But as he approached, the air grew cold, and the usual nighttime sounds of crickets and owls fell silent. A thick, oppressive stillness settled over the field. Tom's voice died in his throat as he realized that no sound was escaping his lips. The figure remained motionless, its face obscured by shadows. Panicking, Tom stumbled backward, the silence pressing in on him from all sides. He turned and ran back to his house, the figure never moving, but its presence lingering in his mind like a dark stain. When he reached his front door, he slammed it shut behind him, but the silence followed him inside. His wife, Sarah, found him hours later, sitting in the living room, trembling and unable to speak. The next day, the town was abuzz with stories of other sightings. People claimed to have seen the Silent Ones standing by their windows, at the end of their driveways, or watching them from across the street. The figures were always the same, tall, gaunt, and silent, their faces never fully visible. It wasn't long before the disappearances began. One by one, people vanished from their homes without a trace. No signs of struggle, no footprints, no sounds. They were simply gone. Families would wake up to find empty beds, their loved ones missing, with no explanation for how or why. The only clue was the lingering silence that seemed to seep into every corner of their homes. In a desperate attempt to understand what was happening, a group of townspeople decided to follow one of the Silent Ones. They waited until nightfall, when the figures appeared once more at the edge of the woods. Armed with flashlights and a sense of grim determination, they followed the Silent Ones as they retreated into the forest. The deeper they went, the quieter it became. The crunch of leaves underfoot vanished, their breathing became soundless, and even the wind in the trees seemed to disappear. Soon, they found themselves standing in a clearing, surrounded by the Silent Ones, who had formed a circle around them. The townspeople tried to speak, but no words came. Panic set in as they realized they had walked right into a trap. The Silent Ones began to move for the first time, slowly closing the circle around them. Their faces, once hidden in shadow, were now visible, pale, featureless, and void of any humanity. One by one, the townspeople felt the oppressive weight of the silence pulling them down. They couldn't scream, couldn't run. The last thing they saw before the darkness took them was the expressionless face of the Silent Ones, their cold, lifeless eyes staring into their very souls. By morning, the group was gone, just like the others before them. Their homes were empty, their names forgotten. The only thing left behind was the silence, thick and unnatural, seeping into the town like a plague. And with each passing night, the Silent Ones crept closer, their numbers growing. Now, in Harrow's End, the silence is a warning, a final, deadly warning. And if you ever hear the silence in the dead of night, pray it passes over you, because once the Silent Ones have chosen you, there's no escape.